Hi guys, this video is about MakeCode and our X-chips, either CS11 or CC03. Later state it could be the CW03, but you have like either a CS11 like I have here, or you have a CC03, you have a OD01 like I have here, and you have some kind of power and programming like the IP03, or maybe you have an IP02. You might have a sensor. It's not necessary for this beginner video. And then we put it together, power it up, we program it and make code, and that's it. So let's get started. Okay, so here we have the chips. So nothing special. This little fellow here, the small connector, is important because when you program this, the programming part goes through this little connector. The big one provides the power in this case. It provides other stuff, but for this purpose, it's power. So this one here is that USB that sits here on the side, okay? And then we have to connect a display. So let me put a display on here. And then let's throw that way. And then we put a sensor on here. So now we have our little circuits here. And now we want to plug it in to the USB. So I have a USB here. It's just that little extension here, so I don't have to show it on the computer. And here's the first problem that many faces. So if I'm just putting it here for a second, then here's a cable. It's a have the right thing. It have this USB-A that fits on this side, and I have the USB micro that fits in here. But it comes with a power bank, and then there's a good chance it doesn't work. So if I plug it in and put it in here, you can see the blue LED turns on, and like there. But if I scroll here on to look here on the locations, I don't have the CS11 or the IP03. So if I take another cable, and there's plenty out there, but it has to be a data cable. It's a short one that fits on the screen here. So I plug that in there. I plug that in here. Like that. So now it's plugged in. And if we go over to the screen, you can see here it says CS11. So now it have a data cable. And it doesn't really matter if it's this beautiful or however it looks. Here is a cable that's very thin. And here's a cable that's considerably thicker. I don't know if you can see the difference. And the important part is that if it's a data cable, you can see the CS11 coming up. You can see the CS11. So this cable here is fine. It will do the trick. So what is the difference? Well, there's four wires inside. In a data cable, two for the USB communication and two for power. In the data cable here, even though it's thicker, there's only two wires inside, and that's just for power. So that's a big difference. So now that we have that, let's power up a browser. So I'm using Chrome. And you can use probably many different browsers. I find Chrome is good for various things. And then you can, sorry. Then you can go to makecode.xinabox.cc. So makecode.xinabox.cc, you can see I have it here already. So if you start that up, you can see there's a big plus button here for a new product. So you click on that and you give it a name. So call my Bjarke and say create, and then you can see here's the CCO3, the CS11, and there's something that's going to look like the CW3. It's not ready yet. It says beta here, so we're playing with it. I have a CS11, so I click on the CS11. And here we have the CS11. Now up here you can see it says JavaScript and blocks. If it's JavaScript, you have to type the code. If it blocks, you have blocks that you can program with. And this is what you want to start with. So make sure you clicked on blocks if it's not already clicked. So in programming in general, there is two parts of a program. There is a part that's where there's something that happened at the start. So you might want to initialize a variable, you might start up something, you might make a sensor ready, you might want to clear a screen. And then you have another part that's a loop. They call it forever here. So what that just means is that it does all the stuff that fits inside, and you will understand what I mean when you see this, and then it just runs it again. On start, runs once in the beginning, forever keeps running what's inside. Okay. So now we want to use our XTips. So in order to use the XTips, on advanced, at the bottom, there's something called extension. You can also click over here on the setting wheel, and up here, number 2 from the top, is extension. It's exactly the same. And then you can see here's our XTips. Okay? So you want to use the earlier one, so you click on the earlier one. So I also have a SW01. If you don't have a SW1, don't click on that, doesn't really matter. If you have a SL06, click on that. So I'm gonna just go in and find the SW1. We have it here. So out here in the side, you can see there's an ODR1 with a little screen on, and there's SW1 with a little snowflake. So in my ODR1 here, I want to print a string. So I start here and I say, I want to actually print humidity. Okay, so this is a label. So it's not the variable, this is a label. So on my screen, I want it to say humidity. Otherwise, when I just print a number, nobody knows what it means. So I put a colon and I put like a little space. And then it says new line. That means that it will go to the next line. Like in a typewriter, cache return or break on your computer, enter. We say no, because we want the next thing to be printed right after that. So the next thing is a number. So we go into ODR1 and say, let's print a number, and we put it here. And now we have a new line. So now I print 0. So we want to have humidity printed out. So I go to SW1, and here you can see there's something called temperature and humidity. So let's take humidity, I put that in there. Now, this thing here will print very fast. So this is all right, but to make this video short and not going back to the different things again and again, if I go back to loops, I have something say pause. So I go in here and I put a pause in and I say a second. In reality, humidity doesn't change that often, so I could maybe go in and put a much longer pause in. But here's my program. I'm not doing anything on start here, so I didn't have to include it. But it might be that there was something else on the screen, I want to clean it up, whatever I want to do. So I will put that here on the start. And then here in the forever loop, I have my first label I print, and then I have this variable here, humidity, and I pause. So let's put it down on the CS11. So I click download here, and in my Chrome browser it comes up so I can see it here. In reality, I click on this and say show in Finder, and it will open up where it is on my, where it saved it. And I have my CS11 here, so now I simply take this and drag it to the CS11, like that. And as soon as it's programmed, it comes up here, and now it's a matter of, if you can see, the results here. You don't seem to be able to see it. So let's see if I can turn this light off and get the camera to then show it. Yeah. So here we go. It shows the humidity there. So that's exactly how I programmed it.